Interesting. Okay. How is this? Okay. Haha. I did it. Okay. We did it, lads. We're streaming now. And since no one is here, since there's one viewer, is there a viewer? I don't know. Because Streamlabs is not reliable. And them's is just the facts. But what I can tell is if there's chatting going on, you know? And if there's chatting going on, I'll see it. Right now, there isn't. So, I guess to start, I'll draw. Oh, how am I gonna do this? Can I make a little pop out with, yes, pop out chat. Okay.
Like live. Oh shoot.
Oh boy, come on. Pop out chat. I'm getting it all figured out. How is that? Does that work? Let's fix that real quick. That's good. And then pop out chat. I know what I'm doing. I swear. Okay. Wish I could make this smaller. Oh well. It's whatever. I can see it well enough. All right, and since there's no chatting going on, what-a-do, I guess I'll start by drawing like one of my OCs. We'll do it in this corner up here. Do-do-do. Who am I gonna draw? Who am I gonna draw? Guess I'll draw Lucien, my current D&D character. Wow, I'm so entertaining. I am the most entertaining person I know. Let's move this over little. Trying to get my. I'm not used to drawing on a drawing tablet anymore. I used to be super used to it, and then something happened called an iPad, and I got unused to drawing on a drawing, t like a proper Wacom. Tablet, and so I'm relearning how to draw basically. But it's fine. Anyway, I love this character a lot. What is this pose? I don't know what the pose is. got a bit of a generic body shape as far as, like, characters that I draw are concerned. I don't know, I really like drawing the, like, short... kind of generically pear-shaped. Why is she jumping? Who knows? Those mirthful leaps that she's got. I was playing a campaign recently, and I was using her. That's wrong. Those lines aren't good. They'll be better later. I'm just doing, like, a general. But, I'm on the wrong layer. We're just gonna... make that a multiply layer. And then we'll fill this one up. Yeah. No longer matters. It's the one I made her for. And I was really excited about the sick leaps that she was going to do because of the satyr's mirthful hop ability. I don't know what's going on with these hands. I'll find out later. And so, but my mic stopped working as soon as I was going to talk about them. And they almost, like, went on because I wasn't saying anything. But I managed to get into the chat fast enough that was like, hey, my mic's not working. What happened was I downloaded a soundboard, but the soundboard made itself my default microphone. So I think I'm gonna have to uninstall it because it keeps messing with literally everything I do. For example, this. It really messed with my setting up the stream. My default microphone got changed so you couldn't hear me. That was the little technical difficulties at the beginning there. Thankfully, I got it. I need to make her head a little smaller. Oh, that's perfect. Okay. But yeah. So that has been an absolute hassle. Luckily, not the worst ever. But still, so. I made her eyebrows a bit more like this. I don't like that, actually. Is this? This is what I set to my undo and redo. Let's actually make her eyes a little... Wow, I don't like that that's the eraser that I'm using. Let's make her eyes a little wider. For being a little more cartoony reasons. She's smiling. Her face is a little high up altogether. Oop. But that's fine. Maybe I can just like, take all of this and move it down. And then not do that. And then I'll change the eyebrows again. Or just this one. Nice. I like that. All right. And then... We got horns on this lass. Love that for her. I love the ears. I love drawing the big fluffy ears on anything, really. Let's do a little. Little fluff. Mm-hmm. I'm really liking this, actually. I haven't done hair like this in a long time. Actually, let's keep that. I used to draw hair, like, fluffy like this a lot. And then, for a while, I just didn't. But I really like the way it's coming out now. The thing about it is, sometimes it just doesn't work, you know? Sometimes you try to draw fluffy hair and it just looks terrible. And what is she? Oh, she's got the necklace. That's floating up. And then her armor, I drew it as like one of these numbers. Where it like sort of tucks in. Okay, actually. Unfortunately, it is boob armor. How unfortunate can it be, though? Let's shape it a little bit more reasonably. Okay, and then it just, like, does this. And then she's got poet sleeves. Because she has to, or else it's not one of my characters. They go all the way. Are those wrists, like, yeah, they're good enough. They're close enough to the same size. Her arms are not. Let's fix that. we go. Yeah, this arm was just way too long. And then hands, I'll figure out later. How does this go? Oh yeah, it goes like this. And then it's gone. Okay. I made this whole part way too complicated. And then it's like... But then these are like... studs. Why are these studs? Who knows? Oh, those are too little. Because there's three. Fluffy. And then we'll do. Oop. That's good. I don't know why her leg bends like that, but I'm not gonna change it. Because I am an artist and I can do what I want. Now, how do I... hands. I've got my hand up in front of me in a pose. Hold on. Let me take a picture of my hand. Okay. Reference picture obtained. You know what? Those are good enough hands. In fact, if I want, I can do like a... like pretend she's holding something. What is she holding? Not an arrow. Maybe if I like move her fingers. Right. Oop, that's not the brush. Cause she's got oh boy. Oh boy, I know what it's called. I know which one it is. I know how to tell them apart, I swear. So little. I made it so little. It's really cute though. I like that. She's just got like a pocket, lyre. You know? Sometimes you don't need a big lyre. Sometimes you need a pocket one. And that's on being a bard. This is too extreme of a curve. Doesn't match the other side. You know, when you're a bard, you just don't always need a big ol' instrument. Especially when you're on the road, skipping town every week, because you scammed everyone and now they all hate you, you know? It's all twisty. That's fun, but I'm not going to keep it. Cool. I've drawn her. Hello. Let's see. Still don't have anything going on in the chat, which is fine. Let me take a short little check my phone break, and then maybe I'll color her. Let's see if I can advertise a little. Huh? Let us see. Maybe I can put on my little animation. Yeah, as fun as it is to look at Lucienne, maybe I can. It's also fun to watch it hit the. Oop! Let me change the text back to what it's meant to be. Transform center on screen. Aha. Watch that hit the corner for a bit. Let's make a little Instagram story, 'cause I'm a cool kid. I'm a cool kid who can use Instagram. Come on. Or can I? Do the thing now. I don't know how you're supposed to do the thing where you add a background to your. Okay, well, that's whatever. I don't know how to use Instagram anymore, apparently. Sorry to my one viewer that this is taking so long. Where is that emoji? I love trying to find emojis. They are so difficult for no reason. I can't figure out why. Cannot figure out why. Now, how on earth did I change the the how it lines up? Oh my god. I don't understand Instagram anymore. Whatever. I don't care. I am annoying my viewer. This is also gonna suck on the recording that I'm gonna upload to my YouTube, because I also do that. Whatever, this is good enough. And then I will keep drawing. What will I do? I will just color Lucien. Boy, oh boy. Oh good, I didn't even change the screen back. Good, 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 good. Because I opened up this. Okay, cool. Cool, cool, cool. I gotta figure it out. I'll figure it out. Let's see. Let's grab her base fur color. And then we'll start coloring. Use pen. Oh, let's erase this. No more BRBing. BRBing crazy. Ahaha. I don't know what that meant. And I'll just hand color. Sometimes, I color different ways depending on what I'm doing. Sometimes, if I'm doing a commission, I will do a selection, a hand selection, all the way around the edge. And then I'll lock the transparency and go in and start coloring so I don't go outside the lines. For this, I don't actually care if I go outside the lines, so I'm just gonna hand color it. Sometimes what I do, when it's just for me, but I care about going outside the lines, is I will fill in all the blank spaces in the line art as you can see, I tend to leave a lot of those. And I will do a selection, an auto selection instead of a manual selection on the outside. And then I will invert that. And once it's inverted, I have the whole image selected. And it usually makes a white, like, border that also gets selected. Not a white border, like a colored border that leaks outside of the line art, because I use pencil brushes and the edges aren't very opaque. But I don't usually mind that. I'll either, if it's like important, if it's like an art fight piece in July, I'll go in and I'll erase around the edges. But if it's just like, for me, I don't really mind that little edge. I don't mind the leaking, basically, is what it is. I love having pen pressure. On the iPad, I don't have pen pressure because it's a iPad 3. And if you don't know why that's, it's an iPad 3 with nothing tacked onto it. It is an old iPad. I got it not too long ago. I got an old one on purpose, because at the time, all I really wanted was the capability to use the Wacom Bluetooth pen. But then I ended up realizing, hold on, completely changes what I'm doing. Let's do something with her real quick. I might like Yeah, okay. What was I saying? Oh, it is 100% gone. All I wanted was Bluetooth compatibility, because I had I wanted one of those Wacom pens that Bluetooth connects to your iPad and gives you, like, pen pressure and stuff. But then I just never ended up using it at all. I would just use it as a straight stylus. And then I got one of those styluses with the clear top. The clear, tip. So that you can see where the very middle pinpoints of the stylus is hitting, and it made my lines way more precise, and I love that thing. I still have it. I still use it whenever I draw on my iPad. Obsessed with it. One of these days, I want to get an iPad Pro. A newer iPad. I want an iPad Pro in the largest size, and then with an Apple Pen, so that I can, like, do really good, like, iPad art. 'Cause as much as I love this, it's not my number one, you know? And so, one day I will have the money for an iPad Pro, or I will get one as a gift, who knows. I've got family. My mom's insane at Christmas. I'll give her, like, options. I tried giving her options one time. I was like, I either want this or I want this. And she was like, I will simply get you both. And I was like, stop that. Not to sound spoiled. I am a little spoiled, actually. Ain't nothing wrong with that. Let's grab the darker fur color. And let's lock this alpha. Protect alpha. Whatever. What is it? It's the ends of her hair. The tips of her ears. Her tail. The top of her tail. And the bottom of her legs. Okay, so like... God, I love Protect Alpha. It makes life so much easier. It's also her hands, right? It's not her hands. I was wrong. And then we'll do, like, the ends of her hair. And then what I do is do I use smudge or do I use blur? What does blur do? I don't use blur. I use mix. Yes. Okay. Yeah. I love using mix. I don't know. I love the texture, you know? I don't love that it doesn't work with Protect Alpha. Don't like that at all. I don't know if there's a setting for that that I can change. Oh, her hair turned out nice. Okay. And then we'll do her eyebrows for personal reasons. Because it looks nice. Yeah, okay. And then do her legs. In the original pic, it did go up to her thighs. I'm not gonna, like, I'm not going to be too much of a stickler about it. Especially not to myself. You know? As much as I would love to ream myself over colors, I will not be doing that. Let's do pen. Oh, Lord. I didn't color her hand. Let's unprotect the alpha. Let's grab, where'd my, there we go. Let's grab this color. Yeah, it makes her thumb look less pointy. Okay. Let's re-protect the alpha. And then we will grab her armor color next. This went from a request stream to a full illustration stream. Not that I mind. Well, I mind a little. I would have liked to have people in here, you know? I'm trying to get that clout. We love to see it. I haven't told anyone in the group chat. I should probably tell them. My friends ought to know. I don't know what shade of gray I'm grabbing. There it is. Okay. Let me go zoom way in. Tonight I'm gonna make a pizza dough starter. I got a skillet to make a pan pizza, and I got bread flour so that my dough is better, like stretchier, I guess. That's what bread flour does, right? It makes it like stretchier. Pretty sure. I do know bread flour is better for pizza dough. So, bought some bread flour. The next color I have to grab is her necklace, gold. Let's zoom in on that. Let's grab this gold. We'll do, oh, and then we'll grab the emerald color. The emeralds. And I believe for her eyes, although I don't like that. Oh, that's not too bad. It looked worse up close. Oop, that's not. That was all right. Oh, that's not bad at all. I am gonna. Bring this back here. Okay. We'll go back to the color layer. What's left? Her layer. And her horns. Oop, her layer's over here. I made everything a slightly different brown color to make up for how much brown there was. Do her horns. I'm not gonna do the, well, I can do the gold strings or like parts of the strings. Horns time. It starts with this color. Wrong layer. I think I made it so like I didn't. That's okay. It can be like that in this picture. Sometimes things change from illustration to illustration, you know? Sometimes the design changes. It's the spice of life, baby.
Baby?
It's the spice of life, baby. I don't know what that voice was. You never heard it. Okay. She's looking done. Unless I want to shade her, but like, that might be pushing it. Should I shade her? I mean, nobody's doing any requests or anything. No one's here. Which is fine. I'm gonna do another stream. I should put up like a schedule, but I'm gonna do another stream. Well, I can't do a schedule because I never know when I'm gonna stream. I know that I'm gonna try to do Mondays and Wednesdays, because those are the days that like I guaranteed have time. Usually, ooh, that vanilla pudding is not doing good. I'm gonna try to do like Mondays around 9 and then like Wednesdays around like in the afternoon, right when my classes end, like at 2. But we'll see how that goes. Once I have a consistent schedule, hopefully I'll get more viewers, you know, hopefully, especially on Wednesdays when it's in the middle of the day, you know, people are on Twitch, you know. I know too is always when I get like the notifications that my streamers that I'm following are streaming. Let's do a multiply layer. Let's just shade for fun, you know. We'll shade with what's a good earthy combination? We can do like red and green. No. That's not good. We'll do blue and orange. Shade and highlight. So I'll shade with blue, and I'll highlight with orange. And I don't really care about being super neat right now. We'll be a little nice to her thighs. Make her a little thick, as the kids would say. I'm the kids who would say, kind of. Dude, I'm old. I'm not old, but I'm older than some people. And that's weird. Growing up is weird, man, you know? I don't know if you've ever done it before, but it's insane. And you don't really know when it happens, and not even just like in a, oh, I don't feel like an adult yet way. Just in like a, like when am I officially like old? Because right now I'm like TikTok old, but I'm not like life old. That didn't make any sense, yo. But, it's just weird. It's weird, you know? In some spaces I'm old, in some I'm not, in some I'm the normal age, and in some I'm not, you know? It just happens to you, and you don't really notice it right away. Somebody points it out to you one day, and you're like, whoa, there. What do you mean? You know? This shading is going to look way better when I go back in, by the way. Thank you. Phoenix for personal reasons. I say that too much for personal reasons. I don't know. I think it's fun. I think it's interesting. It's an interesting way to speak about things. You know? Hold on. Oh yeah, I'm already seeing the results of this shading. It is not clear yet. It won't be for a minute, but oh boy, what a after the minute it will be. My dream job is being a drawfy drawer, drawfy artist. I think that would be so snazzy and nice, you know? To go into work and say, I'm going to draw something good by the standards of men and bad by the standards of me. And I'm gonna be okay with that. Because the challenge was drawing Marvel villains you've never seen with your eyes closed. And no one expected me to do good. And that just sounds like the best career I could fathom. You know? I don't know who could go without having that be their dream job as an artist. I mean, I guess people who get anxious in front of cameras. I mean, I'm not really in front of the camera, but they don't have their webcam on. What I mean is just like speaking to cameras, you know? And I get that. I definitely, this definitely isn't, like, my thing, you know, especially, like, not right now, I guess I could get good at it if I wanted, you know, but that's true about anything. Things don't have to be your thing for you to be able to get good at them over time. When you get good at things over time, they become your thing. You can make them your thing. Oh yeah, that is a satyr booty. You can make things into your thing. And it's real nice. It's very rewarding. But things generally aren't just your thing right away. And that's fine. But I do see how that would drive somebody away from something like being a drawfee artist. A career that I aspire to. I think after that, it would be video game concept artist, like character designer, mostly. Love designing me some characters. Love coming up with concepts. Love video games as a concept. Not good at playing them in any way, shape, or form. I'm not good at them at all. But I do appreciate them as a thing that exists and an art form, which they are, mind you. Oh, her hand. I missed a spot. That is so nice and soft. Let's actually turn the opacity up on that. And let's, let's saturate that. And maybe we'll change the hue a little. That's nice. I like that a lot. That's really soft. I forgot to do her hooves a different color. I'll do them the color of... Do they show? They don't. I'll do them the color of her horns. That is very good. I do like that a lot. And then we'll do an add layer and we'll do bright orange. I'll just do like a couple spots. You know? Yeah, that's good. Got a big mix pen for the Let's get a smaller mix pen for the, let's do a blur on these, and then we'll go back in with more mixing as like a, it's like a ooh, you know? Oh, that's nice. I like that a lot. And then I need a significantly smaller one. And then we will go in here. I'm going with itty bitty little. That is very nice. I'll keep that full opacity. Alright. Not what I planned. I didn't get any requests. But to do a full illustration. Not complaining about that. Cool. I think I'm gonna call it quits. It's been like an hour and a half. I'm gonna put this up on my YouTube. Thank you for hanging out. I should get a good like a goodbye string. Goodbye screen. Oh well.